Hello students, today we are going to take our new lesson, start with it, the civics lesson number 1, the Constitution of India. So first I would like to introduce with the chapter, the title is the Constitution of India, so we should know what the Constitution is exactly means. So students, you must know that we used to play so many types of games, okay. So all these games, if you observe, then you will find that all these games are having a specific rules and regulations which you used to follow while playing that game. Then only we can enjoy the game and we can make a fun with these games. So these rules and regulations are very important. The same it is there with our school also. We will find another example of our school. While studying in a school, we used to follow the rules and regulations of the school. Even at our home, we'll find that some rules are there, or we can say that our parents used to give us the instruction that do this, not to do that, whatever. So all these things means what? We used to follow that rules in our daily routine life. The same it is there with the country. Okay, every institution is having the same sets of rules with which the things can go on a smooth. So in our country also, for the running of the government, there is a need of that same rules and the regulations. Okay, so sometimes these rules and the regulations are in the form of a written. Okay, so these rules and the regulations are considered as a part of the constitution. So we are going to see the correct or a detailed definition of a constitution, that is a written or sometimes unwritten document that contains the rules and the regulations by which a country is governed is called a constitution. So it is considered as the soul of a democracy. For the success of a democracy, the constitution is very much necessary for any country. Then it provides the political stability, peace and solidarity to country. What the solidarity means? What solidarity means? Nothing but only the unity. Okay, so that can be possibly provided to the country with the help of the constitution. Then it also determines the structure of the government, means what type of government it should be there. Then the powers of the government should not be whole and sole powerful, some limitation should be there. Then the functioning of the government, what the functions should be performed by the government. Then the rights and the duties of the people, means what the rights are there for us in our daily life and what the duties we should follow in this. Okay, so all these can be clearly we can get know with the help of the constitution. Then any country needs the constitution for the following reasons. Now what these reasons are there, why the country is really in the need of the constitution? The first point we can say that it lays down the principles. What? It lays down the principles that all the citizens agree to abide. For example, what? One example we can take that our neighboring country in Nepal, there was a monarchy where all the powers in the hands of a king. Means the king was the whole and sole decision maker. But the people raised their voice against it and it led to the change in 1919. After that, the king started to be called as a PM of that country and it lasted for the next 12 years, means they continued with the same for the 12 years. But again, in 2002, King Gyanendra, he took the control of the government in his hand and he started to use his powers unnecessarily. Again, the people raised their voice and in 2006, they refused to follow the earlier constitution and finally in 2008 it declares as a federal democratic republic.
The second point we can say that it describes the nature of the political system, means what type of government it should be there. For example, again with the same, the Nepal earlier it was a monarchy, whole and sole decision power was in the hand of a king, and he was the collapse. However, in a democracy or a democratic setup, what we can say that the constitution plays a very important role, and it lays down the guidelines for the selection of representative, distribution of powers, etc. Then, with the third point, protect the interest of minorities. It protects the interest of minorities means what? The protection should be provided to the weaker sections of the society, and it is the duty of the or the responsibility of the government. So that it is provided by the help of the constitution, and it is through that we can get know that there will be no any more domination by the powerful community over the weaker sections of the society. So for all these purposes we need the constitution. So now we are going to see about the particular of our Indian constitution. Okay, so first, the constituent assembly. It was formed, means the constitution constituent assembly, it was formed in 1946. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was its president, and from December 1946 to November 1949, 300 members from the every sections of the society, they were meeting regularly, and they draft the constitution for Free India. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is called as a father of Indian constitution. He was the chairman of the drafting committee. Then the second challenges faced by framers. Framers means what? The constitution makers. So there were so many challenges in front of the makers of the constitution. That what the challenges were there? There was the political unrest in our country, because the Britishers, the powers from the hands of the Britishers was moving into the hands of the Indian people. Then there was a partition. As we know that at the time of the freedom, our country divided into two nations, that is the India and Pakistan. Then the problem of the princely states was there. So many princely states were there. Some of them wanted to merge with India, some wanted to merge with Pakistan, and some wanted to remain as it is. Then again, a poverty it was there, tremendous poverty it was there in our country, as the no any developmental work was done by the Britishers. So all these challenges were there in front of the constitution makers. Then now the next point we are going to see about the features of our constitution. Okay, so as we know that we accepted the constitution on 26 January 1950. Our constitution, our country's constitution, is the biggest one, as we know. So some features we can say, like the federalism, it is there, which we are following in our country. That is the two levels of government, central and the state. As we know that the India is a vast country, so it is not possible for a single government to run the whole and sole country. So it is divided into two governments, that is the central and the state government. Again, issues or that subjects which are also divided as the union list, state list, and the concurrent list, means the some matters are related with the union government only, about which the whole and sole laws can be made by the central government. That just like the issues about the security of our country, etc. And the next, the some issues that subjects are comes under the power of the state government. For example, the education, related to education, the decisions can be formed by the state government. Okay, and the next is the concurrent list. Concurrent list means what? Where both the governments are having the authority to take the decisions over that issues. Then the third is, the next is the parliamentary form of a government. As we know that we accepted the parliamentary form of a government. That is, in this, the people used to elect their representatives and through the universal adult franchise. That means what? Any citizen who has completed their 18 having the right to vote regardless their social background. Okay, means there should not be any discrimination on the basis of anything. Then the next is the separation of power. Separation of powers means what? There are the three organs of the government, that are the legislature, executive and judiciary. Legislature is a group of the elected representative and they used to frame the laws on the behalf of the entire population of the country. Executives implement these laws and are fully responsible or answerable to the legislature. The judiciary protects the interest of the people of the country. Then the next is the fundamental rights. Fundamental rights means what? Nothing but only that basic rights which we are needed in our day-to-day life. That constitution guarantees its citizens some basic rights which are essential to protect, to maintain the equality, liberty and justice in the country. There are the six fundamental rights. Now I am going to read it out. That is the right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, and right to constitutional remedies. Okay, these are that six fundamental rights which we enjoy in our daily lives. The next is the fundamental duties. Now, we are getting the benefit of these all the fundamental rights. The same manner, it is our duty to do something for our country as well. So, whatever fundamental duties are mentioned, these are not compulsory or enforceable by the law. Some of these are, we have to show the respect to our national flag and anthem. The next is preserve our natural and cultural heritage. This is also our moral duty. Then promote the peace and the harmony in our country. So these are etc. All these are the duties, fundamental duties we can consider. The last point of our lesson, that is, before that, the directive principles of the state policy. These are what the guidelines that help the government to transforming the ideas highlighted in the constitution into laws. So these are what the guidelines which are included with the directive principles. The last point of our lesson, that is the secularism. Secularism is really very important point which is included in our country, in our constitution afterwards. That is, the secular state means what? That does not support any particular religion and treats all the religions alike means what? The same, to maintain the equality. As we know that in our country, so many religious people are living. So there should be the harmony and the integrity in among all, and for this only the secularism it is accepted. Means our country is not having any particular religion. Okay? Means the equal treatment it is given to each and everyone. So it was included in 1976 through the amendments in constitution. Amendments means what? The changes. Our constitution is a flexible one. So as per the requirement of the time, some changes can be made in the constitution, but that is also with the help of some particular processes. So this is called as the amendment. So this is what the lesson it is included. Okay, now I hope that you have understood the lesson. Thank you.